every time I see you, I remember the bad dream that I had. You know, I had another bad dream again last night. Yeah, of course. You wouldn't know. And why would you care either? I mean, do you care again to know my bad dream? Or yes, you want to know? Are you sincere in wanting to know? Yes? I don't know. Last time I told you my dream, I had another bad dream again. So you know what? I'll tell you my bad dream. Hopefully you could pray for me so it doesn't happen. So again, I'm driving on the highway. I'm minding my own business. I'm checking my mirrors. I'm doing everything right. I come to press the brakes because the person in front of me starts slowing down. Guess what? What? All right. I press the brakes all the way and my car is not slowing down. So I realized I haven't checked my brakes for a long time. Yeah, I know. Luckily, we didn't get in any accidents because I was able to slow down to the right side. But then I did check my brakes and I realized that there was some maintenance that I needed to do. So let's discuss some brake stuff and how we can make sure this doesn't happen again. Sounds good? Perfect. Now the brakes are in all the tires, one in the front right, and sometimes you can see through the wheel to see the brake. Sometimes it's better to take it off. So we'll take it off to go through everything specifically. So there's a brake over here, then obviously there's one in the back. Then if you come around, again, one on this side in the back, all right? And then last but not least, there is the last one in the front. So four brakes. When you're braking, usually you end up using your front brakes more because all the weight of the car goes to the front. So you need to change usually your front brake pads and your front brakes more often than you change the back. Now there's also a very critical system of your brake system which a lot of people forget about, and that's the brake oil. So let's check the brake oil because that might have been what caused the brakes not to work this last time. The brake oil, there's a separate container for where the brake oil is kept in the hood. So let's check the brake fluid level and make sure that we're okay. All right, so the brake fluid most of the times is located in the upper right area. And this is, you'll find a separate compartment. You wanna make sure that it says brake fluid on it. In this case, it does say brake fluid, so we're correct. And you wanna take a peek in, make sure that you do have brake fluid. And also sometimes on the side, you'll see lines to know exactly how much brake fluid there is. Now the brake fluid is a very important part of the braking system that a lot of people sometimes forget to check. What happens when you end up pressing your brakes, the pressure from the fluid that goes to all the wheels tightens up, and that's what actually closes your caliper. So your brake pads could be perfect, your caliper could be perfect, but if you do not have enough brake fluid in the car, you won't create that pressure, which then won't slow the car down. So in this situation, we checked our brake fluid and it's good. I'll show you where all the other brake lines are once we discuss the specific components of the brake system. All right, so your basic braking system is right over here. You have, I'll explain the parts of the braking system first, and then I'll explain how everything works together. You have the rotor, which is this round part. You have the caliper, which is this metal part. And in the metal part, you have the brake pads, which are in the calipers. Also, you have all these lines that come to this area. In these lines is where you have your brake fluid, okay? So what happens is you're driving along, the rotor is spinning just as fast as you're driving. When you come to press the brake, it tightens up. And in the caliper, there's the brake pads. So what ends up happening, because the caliper tightens up, the brake pads, which are inside, touch the rotor. And this way, the car slows down. So to check your brakes, you want to make sure, first of all, that your rotor is nice and smooth. If your rotors are no good, sometimes there'll be like scratches in them or lots of deep grooves. In this situation, the rotor is nice and clean, so the rotor is fine. And the brake pads consist of a piece of metal and then a piece of rubber. So that piece of, once you press the brakes, the piece of rubber touches the rotor and the car slows down. If you change your brake pads before the piece of metal touches, then you're gonna keep your car running very nice and smooth. A lot of times you may feel once you press the brakes, the car shakes a lot. That's probably because your rotor isn't good or you need to change your brake pads. So in this situation, our brake pads are good, and our rotor is good, and our brake pads are still good, and the caliper is nice and intact. So our braking system is working great. So just like how it's important for us to check and change our car brakes, it's also very important to check our spiritual brakes. Now, you might ask, what do you mean by spiritual brakes? Spiritual brakes is our ability to stop and to say no. Now, many times people say, but I have spiritual brakes. I know when to say no. But the question is, have you actually said no? Or do you know when to say no, but you don't say no? So very important to keep our spiritual brakes on top and change and make sure to check the oil of the spiritual brakes and to constantly be on top of it. If we feel like we're going the wrong way, we need to press the brakes and say no. Imagine a world without any brakes. We would just be going, the cars, everyone would be getting into accidents and everyone would be leading into sin. So check your spiritual brakes, make sure you know when to use them and that they're working in tip-top condition. Because without them, we won't be able to say no to bad places that we shouldn't be going to. We wouldn't be able to say no to maybe bad friends that we shouldn't be hanging out with. So just like how it's important to check our car brakes and make sure they're in tip-top condition, just as important and more important to check our spiritual brakes. Let us keep our car brakes nice and strong and our spiritual brakes even stronger.